In this little video, I'm going to talk about the MOSFET, and this is the symbol for a MOSFET just here. And the MOSFET that I'm going to be using is actually a power MOSFET, so it's called an IRF510. Okay, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to be looking at its characteristics of how it behaves when you change the gate voltage and the source voltage and things like that. So what I've got set up here is I've got a power supply, which you can't see, but it's set to be about +3 volts. The reason I've not got it in the picture is it just makes it very cluttered. And I've got this here, which is an ammeter, and it's going to measure the current which runs between the drain and the source, because this is the drain and this is the source on my MOSFET. Okay, and this is the gate just here. I have a potentiometer set up, which is this little blue one just here. Okay, and this one runs through a red wire to a battery pack. So that's what this red wire is doing here. The orange wire is running to the power supply, this orange wire here. I'm using a battery pack which is nominally about 6 volts, and that's going to be able to provide my gate voltage. Potentiometer allows me to vary it. My voltmeter here allows me to measure it. And this will be VGS, the voltage between the source and the gate. So I've got two measurements to make. And you may notice I don't have any ammeters or voltmeters. I actually have a data logger here. The reason I'm using a data logger is because it makes life easier. So I'm going to just select my data logger. And as you can see, I've got current on the top and voltage on the bottom. And one of the disadvantages of the data logger is they don't quite read zero when they are in actual fact zero, just because of the way they're sampling. I'm going to do a quick experiment to see what happens. So I'm going to increase the gate voltage. So this is the gate source voltage increasing here. And as you can clearly see, nothing happens to the current. So the first thing we learn is that for a MOSFET, when the gate source voltage goes even up to 1 volt, it doesn't conduct. Let's see how high we have to go before it conducts. Quite a long way. You can get MOSFETs that conduct at a lower voltage, but this one realistically, oh, there you go, just changed. So I'm getting up to 3.2 odd volts before it even starts to think about conducting. This is quite a significant voltage. If you're using a battery powered device on 2 1.5 volt batteries, your MOSFET's never going to conduct because you've only got 3 volts available. So you have to think about that. If we keep going, we find that once we get past a certain sort of voltage, which we call the threshold, the current rises quite quickly. I'm up to several hundred milliamps there. Obviously, the MOSFET's dissipating power because there's voltage and current, so I don't want to go too high, because otherwise what's going to happen is the MOSFET's going to get hot. You should be able to do power calculations. And we go back down again, and the current reduces back down to effectively zero. It's quite nice if we can see this on a graph instead, so hence why I'm using the data logger. So I'm going to go and find my graph tool, and here it is. Select it here. I've set it to measure voltage on this axis. This is the gate source voltage, and current on this axis, which is the drain current. And if we just press place as it starts collecting some data, as you can see, I'm increasing it. It's tracking it along the axis. The current just isn't going up at all. When I get somewhere near the area where it's going to start conducting, the current starts to rise, goes around a corner, and it goes up in essentially a straight line. If I come back down the graph, you see it's symmetrical in both directions, so it follows the curve back down again. And if I just stop collecting data there. Now, the reason that I've got a data logger here is, of course, because I can use it to analyze some of the functionality. So I want to select my slope tool, because I hope you can see that in actual fact, hold on, all gone badly wrong. There you go. In actual fact, this part here is actually almost a straight line, and that gradient is of interest. Now, the gradient that I've got here, you can just about see on the data logger, is 0.544. So I'm going to write that value down. Actually, I'll write it up here. So it's 0.544, and if we take a look at its units, they're amps per volt. So what this means is that the MOSFET, when it's conducting, is increasing the current through the MOSFET at a steady rate as I increase the gate source voltage, at about half a volt, half an amp for every increase in 1 volt of the gate source voltage. Okay, I've actually got some values on here, which I'm going to also take down. So I'll write these down. So here I have, this one here is reading 0.32 amps. And my gate source voltage there is 4.48 volts. And we're going to use these two values to calculate something about the MOSFET itself. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to just turn the gate source voltage back down to zero, because what I don't really want to do is have the MOSFET catching fire halfway through the next calculation. So what we found was, if I redraw my stylized graph, that I plotted the gate source voltage against the current that was being allowed to flow, the drain source current. I got a graph that looks something like this. It got to a certain value, it went around the corner, and then it went up fairly linearly. Now we should know that the equation for a straight line is y equals mx plus c, so we should be able to do something with this. So what was on my y-axis? Well, on my y-axis was the drain source current. What was on my x-axis? Well, that's this axis. Well, this axis was a little bit more complicated, because what was on my x-axis was, if I take this section here, which is the straight line section, what was on my x-axis was the gate source voltage . But it didn't start at zero. And to use y equals mx plus c, or y equals mx would be better, I need to start at zero. So here I have a value, which I already mentioned the name of, which is called the threshold voltage. And what I'm really interested in is how much greater I go along here. Because when I had my values from my graph, what I did is I looked at this point just here. These are the values I took off my data logger. So this was 0.32 amps, and this value here was 4.48 volts. And what I'm really interested in is not the 4.48, but I'm interested in how far it's gone from there to there, how much it's turned on by. So what I actually need to do on my x-axis is have the gate source voltage minus the threshold voltage. So that number in brackets there is that distance there. Okay, that distance along there. Now I can work out my gradient of this line I've drawn in orange. It's that and that. Those are the two values we need. Okay, and that gradient has a name. It's called the transconductance, and it's given a symbol. It's given a symbol GM. Okay, and this is what I actually measured up here. It's the rise in current, the y-axis, per change in voltage, the x-axis, the gradient of that section there. Okay. Now, if we have a look at this equation, this is a variable, which we measured. This is a constant, which the data logger gave us directly. This is a variable, which we varied with our screwdriver, and we don't know this value yet. It's not the value where you first start to get conduction. It's not this point here where you first start to get your current to change. It's not that. It's the extrapolation back down of this straight line. It's the theoretical, if you had a corner there, it would be where that corner is. So we need to actually calculate it. Okay, let's see if we can have a go at doing that. It's not a particularly difficult calculation. So what we're going to do is we're going to put our numbers that we have from here into this equation. So we'll call this an example. Okay, e.g., we get 0.32 equals... okay, GM, which is 0.544. I didn't take the exact value of this 0.319 off the data logger, because I've already got a little bit of an offset on there anyway, so I'm not working at that level of precision. This is my gate source voltage, which gave me this particular current, 4.48. And this is the value I'm trying to find, the threshold voltage. Okay, so simply a case of rearranging all of that. So hoping your maths is good enough for this if you're doing A-level electronics. That goes down the bottom of there. That goes over that side. This lot goes over that side. So you get 4.48 minus 0.32 over 0.544. So my threshold voltage comes out to be, if I get my calculator out, so here it is. So we go 4.48 minus, open brackets, 0.32 divided by 0.544, close brackets, equals 3.89 units of volts. So what we can say now for our MOSFET, and we've investigated it, we've measured it, we can say that the threshold voltage is approximately 3.9 volts. And that's the first part of what we're going to do. We're going to need to actually switch circuits now and look at the second characteristics in just a moment.